Bueno, gracias a todos por venir. Es para nosotros un honor estar organizando este evento de un tema que obviamente es muy interesante para todos. Tenemos speakers realmente muy variados y muy interesantes para compartir con ustedes. Voy a empezar por contarles un poco el objetivo del evento. Generalmente hacemos muchos eventos que tienen que ver con tecnología, obviamente es nuestro expertise. En todas las tendencias que tienen que ver con lo que está cambiando los negocios alrededor del mundo. Pero también sabemos que para que esa tecnología genere un impacto en el negocio, también tenemos que acercar aquellas tendencias que van a generar un impacto desde distintos puntos de vista en el negocio, no solamente desde la tecnología, sino en los cambios de hábitos, en los cambios de paradigma. Y por eso hoy el evento está enfocado desde ese lugar, desde un lugar de cómo en la estrategia de mobile de nuestras compañías tenemos que tener en cuenta distintas cosas que están pasando, no solo en la tecnología, sino en el resto de los negocios. Con lo cual, la idea es que hoy se puedan llevar dos, tres cosas para pensar y que les generen un impacto en su día a día. Voy a compartir primero con ustedes un poco la agenda, después los voy a ir presentando más en detalle a cada uno de los que van a estar con nosotros. Primero vamos a tener unas palabras del CEO de GlobalLogic, Shashank Samant, que vino especialmente para el evento, para también compartir con nosotros su visión. Luego, Alejandro Prinz, que muchos de ustedes seguramente lo conocen, han tenido el placer de escucharlo en otros eventos. Va a darnos un panorama más numérico de tendencias, él también es economista, así que siempre le pone un poco de ese touch. Así que vamos a ver dónde estamos parados y hacia dónde vamos y qué es lo que está pasando. Luego también ha venido desde lejos Mary, que es VP de Digital River, uno de nuestros clientes importantes en Estados Unidos, con un fuerte foco en Global Commerce. Así que vamos a tener visión latinoamericana, visión global. Y después continuamos con un panel que llamamos Mobile Business y donde distintos panelistas nos van a contar desde distintas industrias cómo está impactando el crecimiento y la masificación de mobile. Después vamos a hacer un pequeño break para que puedan tomar más café y tener más energía. Y seguimos con otro panel que tiene que ver con la experiencia de usuario. ¿Cuál es el impacto de la experiencia de usuario? ¿Qué tenemos que tener en cuenta? También desde la visión de muy variada de distintas industrias y distintos speakers muy interesantes. Y vamos a finalizar con algo especial que tiene que ver con cómo impacta todo este cambio cultural y tecnológico que tiene que ver con social media y especialmente en mobile. Y para eso nos acompaña Gaby Menta, que es experto en el tema y creo que les va a resultar muy interesante escucharlo. Algunas cuestiones de agenda. Como hay mucho contenido, es difícil poder meter preguntas en el medio. Igual lo vamos a intentar en los paneles que queden un poco de tiempo. Tienen unos papelitos ahí con ustedes. Si quieren ir poniendo preguntas que se van ocurriendo y a qué orador, en los momentos que vaya quedando lugar, haremos las preguntas más relevantes y si no, igual serán todas contestadas por mail después del evento. ¿Qué más? Tengo anotado para no olvidarme. Bueno, obviamente, algunas de las charlas van a ser en inglés, las de, sobre todo, obviamente, Shashank y Mary, con lo cual, los que necesiten tienen unos auriculares. Les pido que los que no lo van a usar, los pasen para atrás, por si alguien más lo necesita. En las carpetas van a encontrar una encuesta. Siempre nos ayuda mucho conocer su opinión para los próximos eventos, material que desarrollamos, por compartirlo. Así que, bueno, les pedimos que antes de finalizar el evento, si la pueden completar, también nos va a ser de mucha utilidad. Bueno, espero que disfruten el evento. Los dejo con Shashank, que, bueno, yo Shashank lo conozco ya hace varios años. Para mí tiene una visión de la industria muy, muy interesante por su trayectoria. Shashank tiene más de 24 años en la industria. Empezó de un lado del mostrador, en Citibank. Fue pasando por compañías donde se puede ver la gran escala en tecnología, como HP o IBM. y hoy está del lado de la innovación. Hoy nosotros ayudamos a las compañías que innovan a generar esa innovación y a llevarla al mercado en cosas que quizás van a estar visibles o disponibles dentro de un par de años. Así que, bueno, creo que les va a interesar mucho escucharlo. Gracias.
Gracias. I should start with saying that Buenos Dias, good morning. Every time Sebastian introduces me in any of the meetings and he speaks in Spanish, I really feel ashamed for myself. I live in California for the last 25 years. 37% of Californian population speaks Spanish. 50% of the kids which are born are Spanish. 67% of the new kids that learn Spanish in the school, and my 4.5-year-old daughter Sonia can speak better Spanish than me. So I made a resolution over here that next time, a year down the line, when I'm going to be in the conference, at least a part of it I should speak in Spanish. So it will help me to actually get connected a little better. I'm among actually those CEOs who are very fortunate, who can make my passion as business. Technology is my passion. You can see that I'm using Google, that's me, on Nexus, and I have iPhone Pi, which is tucked in at my belt. And when you make your passion as a business, it's no more a business, it's fun. We call GlobalLogic as a toy factory, not in a weird sense, in a good sense, because all technologies which we work with some of the best companies in the world, we get a bragging right to bring those out to the market even before anybody knows about us. As a CEO, actually, the other fortunate part for me is I started my career with Citibank. So I used technology to get the advantage to the business. So I wasn't a nerd, actually. I was using technology to get the advantage in Citi. After that, almost 10 years, I worked with HP and IBM. So we were custodian to build a new technology and try to bring to the market. We used to think that we owned the technology in those days, 1990s, right? And last 10 years or so, I am working with GlobalLogic and similar companies trying to get academia, industry, and the CIOs to get together and try to apply technology to change the businesses, trying to give the business what you saw in the video, which is both edge and efficiency. If we do that, then we satisfy the mission of GlobalLogic. That means to improve the human life and to save the human life. We do work with medical devices segment, which actually saves the human life, including pacemakers and everything else that happens along with that. GlobalLogic has 6,000 engineers around the world. We are truly a global company. I cannot say that I'm an American company, I'm a Ukrainian company, a Chinese company, Indian company, Argentinian. It's truly global, 6,000 engineers. We work with 250 product companies and CIOs. And these are as big as Capital Ones and Telecom and Google of the world. And they are as small as a startup in the Silicon Valley, which 6 years back called it Zappos, now part of Amazon. Like this broad spectrum. We work across close to 600 product lines with these 250 companies. We call everything as a product when the technology has a life. So it's not really the product which you can hold in your hand, but you can apply it and which is going to have its life. We release close to 3,000 software releases every year, over 3,000. Some of those are for the companies like LinkedIn, which has a 15 days release cycle. We work also with Twitter, which is 2 days release cycle, by the way. And some of them, like medical devices companies, which are release cycles of 3 years. You can see that actually vast spectrum which we operate in. If you really get it one step further, then I'll give you a spectrum of companies we work with. In social and digital revolution, we work with companies like Google and LinkedIn. We are one of their important labs. Google is one of the largest clients. We work every single map you touch. Actually, we are part of the revolution. We work with LinkedIn. LinkedIn is becoming the next generation SAP and Oracle. We really do not believe that SAP and Oracle will have a fortune in terms of trying to connect the HR systems, because most of your company's data and people data is live on LinkedIn more than actually anything else. On the telecom side, we work with Telecom, we work with Verizon, we work with Sprint, we work with British Telecom, and this is in all the way from the old areas like BSS and OSS to getting the front-end area of connected devices, M2M, connected cars, so on and so forth. Take it further, we work with media, companies like Sky, companies like Fox, trying to get the new content out to the market. Just to give you the idea, that the first time the live broadcasting, 3D broadcasting of the Soccer Cup happened in London, all the three companies which we had got together, Avid, Sky, and Sony, all of them were working with us, and we were actually center of their mixing studio. So you can see that actually where all we go. And last but not the least, we work with the financial world. Almost 40% of the IT spending happens in the financial world. So companies like Capital One, companies like JP Morgan Chase, they rely on us in order to build their next generation systems. So it's really a beautiful business, right? You see that when I talk to my wife, when I talk to my friends, I always have the bragging rights in the party, saying that, you know what, this new device is coming out. This is actually happening with reference to Google Jelly Bean. This is what is happening in the medical devices. This is the way Square is changing the technology in the banking world. And this is the reason JP Morgan CIO, Guy Chirillo, just happened last week, said that we are a technology company first, happens to have financial expertise. So most of you over here, though you come from CIO's office, you are actually building a technology company, and your line of business or expertise, it just happens to be in happenstance. Now we also have an unfair advantage, because we work in the ranks, working on technology, but because we work with almost close to 250 companies, we see the technology changing, and by the way, across the world, from 35,000 feet. And the first time in my at least 25 years in industry, I'm seeing is no more a technology wave. What we are seeing is a perfect storm brewing with six of seven things happening simultaneously. Today's products are not built by engineers, they're built by designers. It's design first. I mean, any of you have seen the video for Jonathan Ivey of Apple? He talks very eloquently for iPhone 5, right? He talks about, we challenge the engineering by saying that how we are going to design the product and engineering is supposed to supposed to deliver it. The second thing is a social revolution. Everything which we are doing, even our buying pattern decisions are dictated or are controlled by the social patterns. And there is a session today and I'm really curious to listen more and to learn more about it. Third thing is cloud. I literally, if I lose my laptop today or tablet today, I can get activated on Sebastian's within probably, last night we were talking about it, less than 5 minutes, just to get my password set up. Everything is in cloud. I don't have to, I'm not tied to a particular equipment and instrument. The fourth is security. All this is making security more complicated. The first time a year back, one of the prime company, Medtronic, which actually creates the pacemakers, their medical device, a diabetic device, got hacked. When last time the medical device company was thinking about security? But security is becoming paramount importance. And lastly is the analytics. All the data we are gathering, that is ultimately telling our behavior to the guys like you so that you can do a target market. If you put all these five or six trends together, if you look at this perfect storm, the eye of the storm is mobility. It's really, because mobility is the one which is trying to bring everything together. And that is the subject of this conference, that is the subject of this summit today, just to churn our brains around it. If we leave this room by a little more knowledgeable, including myself, including Sebastian, then actually we achieve the purpose. So we just want to have a good discussion over here. I just want to share a few numbers just to tell you, share how monumental this is in terms of this perfect storm. As of right now, and this is what IDC data, this is not my data, most of the research report has IDC as the base. This is IDC Feb data. There are 5.9 billion mobile devices in the world. That means every 100 people, there are 85 mobile devices. Now you might think that, oh, that's fine, what's so big deal? We have, for the population, we have 85% coverage on mobile device. Out of 6.5 billion population, 2.5 billion people don't even have their running toilets. So mobile device becoming more important than their bodily needs. 600 million people don't have even drinking water, but they have, many of them have mobile device. 1.5 billion of those are in developed countries. 4.5 are in developing countries. This is the first time developing countries are running over the developed countries, because developing countries do not have the baggage of changing some ecosystem. The countries like India, they don't have landline. They're nothing to replace. The mobile phone is the one actually they start with, right? We have 1 billion mobile phones in Americas, and that is US just had 105% coverage, which is just close to around 350 million. So rest of actually 650 are rest of the Americas. You can see that how powerful is that. If you add the mobile broadband, there are 1.2 billion devices more. JP Morgan conference, Guy Chirillo said the other thing. Many of us are carrying 3.5 devices. We have our PC or whatever, MacBook Air or anything we want to have. We have our tablet, we have our mobile device, and we have a Wi-Fi connector. 3.5 devices is no more bring your own device, is bring your own device 3.5. And CIOs are challenged to figure out how they are going to make that part of the ecosystem. And obviously they save money, right, when they do that. If you really try to go one step further, there are 1.6 mobile devices were sold in 2011, which is 11% up than 2010. And we believe that trend is going to continue. Just if you see how much Samsung sold on Galaxy, just on mobile device, or Apple sold in the first 5 days, or first 3 days, 2 million plus, that shows that how much is adoption. When you come to the tablets, and which is a big topic of debate, whether it's a mobile device or whether it is, and Mary is going to talk about it, or whether it is going to be a laptop, right? The tablets, there are 68 million tablets which are sold in 2011. 106 million are expected to be sold this year, and is going to go to 200 million within the next 2 years. But yet, mobile devices or mobile phones, they outweigh tablets 22-1, right? Is that 1.6 billion sold versus 100 million? And you have to figure out actually where you're going to put your money in that proportion. Last but not the least, and this is very important, because oftentimes many of us live in the US, we feel that we dominate the technology and dominate the world. Not so. Out of the 10 biggest mobile operators in the world, the US operator, the only US operator which ranks in the list is AT&T, and that's 7th. China has 2, Latin America has 2, including Mobile Movero. India has 2, and Europe has 2. US is only one operator, AT&T, which is actually goes down with 200 million, almost close to 198 million subscribers, including car and everything, which goes down to 7. So this whole mobile revolution, it might have started as a technology in a few universities on the west coast of US, right? But at this point, the adoption of this curve is happening in the rest of the part of the world. And that is my sole interest, how exactly Argentina is adopting that. How that the corporates, how the CIOs are adopting that. How you are changing your business on what you see is going to be disruptive in terms of how we are going to use to change the human life. So like all of you, I'm very curious about this summit. I'm going to take the second row seat over here. I'm going to listen because this also makes the strategy for my company for next 3 years. So Sebastian, thank you for inviting me, and let's start the summit. Thank you all.